Okay. So, we're going to kind of wing it this morning. We're all prepped out, but we were prepped out. I was prepped out with an organist, and I forgot that apparently Miss Connie's not with us this week. So we'll get music going here in just a few, unless we've got an organist that wants to play. Unless anybody wants to play. Or piano. Anybody want to step up? I didn't bring my guitar today either, so. All right, so we're going to do some music here in just a minute, but we're going to go ahead and go along in our service. Get going. We'll start off with a couple of announcements. I'm just going to put that down because the slides, everything's off today. Just ignore, don't even put your bulletin down, don't even worry about it. We're just going to wing it today. So today is actually kind of appropriate that we're going to kind of wing it today because we're going to open our lives up to a presence right now. We're going to open our lives. Today's very special. I'm excited about today's message because it is the root of all of our discipleship. Here's the thing. It is like everything about what it means to be a Christian. Are you ready for that message? Like, do you want to know, like, is that what you, I'm sure that's what you want, right? Like, hey, just give me that sermon that tells me everything I need to know about being a Christian, and I'll be good. And I won't have to come back to church. I can just go do it. But that's this message, so don't miss out. Listen up. So we'll get going here in just a few. Right now, we're going to open with prayer, though. If you want to take a big, deep breath, we'll do some announcements here a little bit. I know we got a couple of announcements, right? Just holler at me.
Why did you remember that?
You really expect, like, we've known each other for, like, 3 years now, and you expect me to remember something. Especially while I'm up here. I zone out. So everybody just kind of take a big deep breath, will you, for me? Oh, feel that? Feels good. Feels good to take a big deep breath. Breathe in that grace of God. Breathe in that air of salvation. Breathe in that very life that God has gifted you. Let's go ahead and close our eyes now. We're going to close out all the world as well. Everything outside those doors, everything even outside of these own bodies right now, just shut it down. We're going to go inside of ourselves right now and just focus on our relationship with God. So take a big deep breath and let's go to the Lord in prayer. Gracious God, we just thank you. We thank you for this time that we come here. It's always in your name that we gather, Lord. We just ask that you bless and anoint this service today. Bless and anoint our time together today, Lord. Bless and anoint each and every single person here with us today. Lord, lift their souls, lift their spirits to meet yours. Lord, open our lives to you. Let us dive into this relationship that you so freely offer to us that we so easily turn away from. Lord, open our eyes to you today. Let us feel your spirit. Let us feel your presence in a real and tangible way. It's in your holy name that we pray. Amen. We'll go ahead and jump up to our announcements now before I forget. So, Travis, did you want to make an announcement? Do you have an announcement, or do you want me to make the announcement? I feel like it'd be more authoritative coming from you.
So, as everybody knows, we are replacing our janitor custodian position. Should have received an email last week.
Custodial engineer.
Sure. Custodial engineer. That sounds like it costs an awful
lot. That's an expensive position.
It's hard to pay. But so we have two interesting people today. We are going to be, the PPR is coming together right after church. If you did not remember that about the PPR, that I touched bases with everybody. Reminder again, yes, we're coming together right after church. If anybody else that is here in the congregation that wishes to talk to us about the custodial position, like I said, we're going to have a real quick meeting, interview a couple people right after church. If you're interested, please step forward. Just catch me or somebody else in the PPR right after church. But we will have a decision made by today who's going to be taking care of everything. Custodial-wise, who's be taking care of?
You want to share with them who the PPR committee is?
Who the PPR committee is? What, is anybody on the PPR committee in here? Everybody raise your hand if you're on the PPR committee.
If you're on the PPR, stand up.
Yeah, there we go.
Rick Ballman, stand up.
Yeah. That's dang near a quorum.
Yeah.
guy you got in your bulletin you can check out there. Some upcoming events. We want to really press on the Back to School Bash, August 2nd. Come check out the Back to School Bash, August 2nd, 4 to 7. Do we need anything for that? Is everything going good for that? We need more volunteers. That's the story of our life here. We need more volunteers. Do I need to do it like I did the other week with the money? I need four volunteers. Who's going to volunteer? I need four volunteers. Give me four volunteers. There's Connie. I got a volunteer there. Anybody else want to volunteer right now? All right, we got them right here. Look here. Like, they're springing up everywhere. If you want to volunteer for the Back to School Bash, we need more volunteers. We need more bodies. We need more people. So, see Miss Lori, Miss Amy, if you like, Miss Brandy, Miss Lindsay, maybe. Don't come to me, though, because I'll just send you to them. So go to them. I don't know nothing about nothing. Yeah, the other announcements in your bulletin there, the Zoom Easy Bay trip, that's coming up pretty soon, so look forward to that for our kiddos. The Zoom Easy Bay, August 11th, we'll be going up Sunday. What's our time?
I don't know, are you
going to
do the sermon?
No, I'm passing the bus.
Okay.
So we're going to leave earlier.
We will leave here at 10.
Zoom Easy Bay trip, leaving here August 11th at 10 o'clock. August 11th at 10 o'clock, we will be leaving here. That is a Sunday. So we'll have church on the road. I will not be here. I'll preach the whole way, I promise you. They'll get an hour-long sermon in the van. You guys will get a nice guest speaker who will do a wonderful job and get you out of here on time. So I'll be praying for that trip, and if there is any other volunteers or folks who want to go on that trip, but get all your kiddos rounded up for that trip, and we're covering it, right? That's church, so any kids that's interested, bring them. We'll take them to Zumbezi Bay if we have to rent a Greyhound. So, and also the basement. Looking forward to Wednesday in the basement again. Past Wednesday, if you saw it, was not a very good feed. Sorry, kind of messed up on some things. I was trying something new. But if you follow up on Wednesdays in the basement, that's our online thing, and I invite you to. You're welcome to join us there at the house in person over in Washington Courthouse. But we just do the basement on Wednesdays to kind of follow up and retouch, touch base again with our gospel scripture we'll talk about today, which is an exciting one. So, be tuned in to Wednesday at 7:30 on the basement on the Facebook Live on the basement's page. Any other announcements that need to be made that I'm missing? We good? Okay.
Is the Back to School Bash this Friday?
The Back to School Bash is August 2nd. That is, yes, this coming Friday.
And do we still need donations?
Yes, I mean, yes, we'll always take stuff. We always take stuff. But yes, donations and volunteers. Yes. I like doing this sometimes because I feel like a politician. Any other announcements? Okay. All right. Let's turn to our psalm reading today, Psalm 85, if you'd like to follow along then in your Bibles, Psalm 85. Lord, you poured out blessings on your land. You restored the fortunes of Israel. You forgave the guilt of your people. Yes, you covered all their sins. You held back your fury. You kept back your blazing anger. Now restore us again, O God, of our salvation. Put aside your anger against us once more. Will you be angry with us always? Will you prolong your wrath to all generations? Won't you revive us again so your people can rejoice in you? Show us your unfailing love, O Lord, and grant us your salvation. I listen carefully to what God the Lord is saying, for he speaks peace to his faithful people. But let them not return to their foolish ways. Surely his salvation is near to those who fear him. So our land will be filled with his glory. Unfailing love and truth have met together. Righteousness and peace have kissed. Truth springs up from the earth and righteousness smiles down from heaven. Yes, the Lord pours down his blessings. Our land will yield its bountiful harvest. Righteous Righteousness goes as a herald before him, preparing the way for his steps. The word of God, the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
All right. At this time, can I have all my youngsters up here today? All my children. I got a whole row of them up here. Whole row of them back. I love it. I love it. It's exciting. Let's try to do this thing. See here if I can do this. Without messing it up. Coach. Coach. It's kind of side-wiggered, but y'all just tilt your head. You'll be all right. Morning, children.
Good morning.
Yeah, that was exciting. Good morning, children.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
That's a little bit better. How is everybody this morning?
Good.
Everybody good? It's a beautiful day. Did you guys see how beautiful it is outside? It's awesome. It's awesome. Have you guys ever make wishes? I made a wish last night. I did it for the first time in a long time. It was the first star. Have you ever heard that old rhyme? Starlight, star bright, first star I see tonight. I wish I may, I wish I might, have this wish I wish tonight. I did that the other day. For the first time, like, I don't know why it popped in my head. Did you know that there's a lot of things that we can actually wish for? There's a way that we can kind of wish for things that a lot of times they come true. Did you know that? Did you know that really everything in your life that you really wish for and hope for is attainable? You can do it. You can have it. Isn't that crazy? Did you know that? You have that power. It's like being able to say, I wish I could do that, and you can do it. You have that power. Did you realize that? Did you realize that? It's as if you can do anything you want if you put your mind to it. Have you ever heard anybody say that? If you put your mind to it, you can do anything you want. Because it's true. It's so true. When everything in your life is directed towards what you want, those little wishes in our lives, Lord, I wish this, I wish that. Now, here's the problem. What if you got everything you actually wished for? Now, wouldn't that, it'd be awesome, right? But can you imagine some of the problems that would actually come along with it? If you actually got everything that you wanted, if you just wished for it and you got everything you wanted. So we actually have to be careful what we wish for if it, in fact, comes true when we want it, right? So what do you guys really want in your life? Is it really candy that you want? Or is it happiness? Is it those toys? Or is it those joys?
Joys.
Right? So those are things that we really want, but here's the problem. And I'm preaching to the big kids right now, too. This is awesome. I might just keep going right on into this. Here's the problem, though. We wish for, and we think about, and we pursue all the things that we think will make us happy instead of pursuing happiness. Guess what? You don't get what you want. You don't get all this stuff, but you will never find that happiness. But you'll get what you want. You'll get what you ask for. You'll get what you pursue. Listen, so that you can hear them out there. They're thinking about this too right now. It's going to get good today. I'm spirit with this today. Whatever you guys want, whatever you guys want to be, whatever you guys want to do, you can do it. You can be it. Just be careful what it is that you want to be and want to do. Make sure it lines up with God. Make sure it lines up with the life of Jesus. Because whatever it is you pursue, I promise you, you put your minds, your hearts, your bodies, and your spirit into it, it's going to get done. You can move mountains. Each and every single one of you can move mountains if you believe in yourself enough. But make sure those mountains you're moving are the ones that God wants you to move, okay? Pursue that happiness. Pursue that joy. Pursue that life in Christ. And I promise you, you'll get it. Don't worry about all that other junk. It'll take care of itself. You just pursue God, and you pursue happiness. Pursue that love that God gives, and you'll get it. Amen? Does that sound good? That's easy, right? You don't have to get a whole bunch of different stuff to make you happy. You can just pursue one thing. You can just think about one thing. That's all you got to do, and you'll find it. Let's pray, guys. Gracious God, we just thank you for this time we gather here. We thank you for these young people here. We ask that this time be encouraging to them. This time be exciting to them, Lord, that they can feel your presence, that they can hear your word, that they can on their hearts, Lord, lay your call.
Lord, we thank you for that opportunity. We just ask that they, in all they do, pursue you in your love and your grace. Let us be good stewards of your mercy to them, be good examples in their lives. It's in your holy name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
You guys can head on back.
Come on.
Oh yeah, we got it this way. Jake, do we have any music? We've got some music. Would you guys like to sing a hymn? It's in my slideshow. Ain't you fancy? Would you all like to sing some music? Oh, is it, Jay? Can you just play it from back there, brother? Can you do it from back there? We'll go on to our praises and prayers while you set it up. I don't have it up here, so. Does anybody have any praises and prayers this morning? Flip all my buttons and switches. Yes, ma'am. Stem cell transplant, and we'll be suffering some effects from that in the next week or so. So pray for David. What's that?
I don't think Lori can hear us.
David Doles. Did you get down? Listen. Anybody else? Ms. Lance?
I just want to thank everybody for your prayers.
Anybody else? What's his name?
Kanan Knowles.
Kanan Knowles got burnt real bad in a grilling accident. Really bad. Okay. I'll be praying for him for sure. Definitely. Anybody else? Yes, ma'am.
Eric and Rich, little girl trying breast cancer. Mm-hmm. They had a fundraiser for my granddaughter did, and they raised $9,000 for medical treatment.
Oh, wow. That's a blessing. Mm-hmm. Continue prayers for her for sure, but yeah, blessing on $9,000 raised. Amen.
Yeah, they said when she got up, she said she never felt so much love for everybody there. She was so appreciative.
But yes, praises or prayers, tests and testimonies.
Praise for the help of the impact.
Yeah,
good vacation. Big branch and those trying times in the hospital.
Yeah. Okay. Well, good. He often is.
Glad you're back. We can't hear back here.
Huh?
We can't hear.
Hey, you know there's all kinds of seats right here. Hey, y'all see this right here? Front three pews. Wide open.
We're thankful to have Doug back. That was one of the last words.
Any other praises or prayers this morning? Tests or testimonies? All right. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. I'm sure we've got some silent prayers too that you want to lift up right now. That's fine. Please do that. Take this time, because we're going to be talking about prayer today. So take this time to really open your hearts. Let's really pray this time, okay? I mean, I know I'm guilty just because everybody is. When it's that prayer time, we just kind of close our eyes, we zone out, and we might start balancing our checkbook, or we might text or see if anybody did anything on Messenger or whatever. Take this time right now to really pray. Really think about what it is that you want in your life right now. Pursue something in your heart and in your mind and in your spirit right now. You want healing? Pray for healing. Think about healing. Pour all your energies into healing. If you want guidance, if you need direction, if you need discernment about something, pray for that right now. Focus on that. Concentrate on that. Open your heart to discernment, not to the answers you want, but to the answers that are out there. God is waiting to fill that void in your life, whatever it is. That hole that has not been filled for years and years and years. That pain that has been just festering under the surface. It's there. Recognize it. Think about it. Pray about it. Focus on that being removed, washed under the blood of Christ. That's the point of this. You believe it. You focus your entire being on what you want to happen. And trust me, it will happen. Careful what we pursue. If we are pursuing our own wills, if we are pursuing our own wants, if we are pursuing our own whims, we're going to be real nervous when the results happen. Maybe we haven't taken this time, church, to stop and really think about what it is that we want. Maybe that's why no results are happening. Maybe that's why we pray. Maybe that's why we think about stuff, but we never have anything that we know that we want. We're scattered, right? This world does that to us. It pulls us in every direction. We can't pull our focus into one thing. Take this time to do that. What is that one thing? We're going to talk about some of that here in just a minute. But I promise you, if that one thing is your relationship with God, everything else will fall in place. It's incredible how that happens. So I encourage you now, I ask you now, I implore you now, during this time of prayer, seek God. Knock on the door of heaven. Ask for God to show you the glory that he has in store for you. And I promise you, he won't let you down. Let's close our eyes and open our hearts and go to the Lord in prayer. Gracious God, we come before you today with humble hearts. Come to you today with seeking souls. Lord, we come to you with a million questions. Lord, we want all those questions answered now. We need those things in our lives to be known. That is our downfall. Afraid of faith. We're afraid of trust. Lord, we fear the worst and we think about it constantly. Lord, we regret the past and we think about it constantly. Lord, we are scared to death right now. Think about it constantly. Lift that fear from our lives today. Lift those chains from our hearts today. Lord, unshackle us from the burden of our human nature today. For one moment, Lord, give us your glory. Give us your presence. Give us your grace and grace alone. That is what we seek. Your light, your love, your mercy, your presence. Today, no matter what's going on around us, no matter what situation is happening with us, Lord, help us keep our focus on you. Help us keep anchored to the rock. It's in your holy name we pray. You taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. I believe we're going to stand and sing a hymn now before our message. Fingers crossed. I believe it's going to happen. Boom. Looky there. All right. If you would now, let's stand and sing this hymn. This is what it's all about. This is what we're talking about right here. This is our prayer. We were just praying. We're going to talk about seek ye first the kingdom of God. Stand and sing this with your open heart, open mind, and really feel these words today, okay?
Be seated.
I like the drum, but Our scripture today is out of Luke 11. We're staying in Luke this week. We're on the and I think this is like one of the like go-tos as a disciple of Christ, but also just as a seeker of God, and a seeker of grace, and a seeker of his presence. So I'm going to read here from Luke 11. It's chapter 11, starting with the first verse. Once Jesus was in a certain place praying. As he finished, one of his disciples came to him and said, "Lord, teach us to pray just as John taught his disciples." Talking about John the Baptist. If you imagine those guys back in the day, to put it in context, you know, Jesus and John both have these ministries going on. It's kind of like crosstown ministries. Some people like John, some people like Jesus. Most people didn't like any of them. But like, it was kind of like little churches, you know. If you visited another church in town there and they were doing something really cool when you came back and you're like, "Hey, man, they're doing this over there at that church. We should do it here." It's the same kind of concept. Like, why do they do it over there and we don't do it here? So that's kind of what it's like. Just put it in context. So Jesus said, "This is how you should pray." This is it. Listen, okay? Want to be a Christian? want to follow Christ? Like, when the Bible says, Jesus said, pay attention. And then when it says, when Jesus said, "This is how you should pray," pay attention. We're going to be Christians here. We're going to follow Christ, Jesus Christ. We want to follow him. So when he says, "Jesus said, this is how you should pray," that's enough. And we can dissect this, and I love it. This is the Lord's Prayer. We just prayed it. And we can dissect it, and people do. People preach sermon series just on the Lord's Prayer because it is so powerful. This should be powerful in our lives. This is what Jesus said. This is how you should pray. I don't know how to pray. I hear people say it all the time. Oh, I love that as a pastor. You get to pray everywhere you go. It doesn't matter. You get to pray over a meal. You pray over. It does not matter. When you're the pastor, you pray. I always try to encourage other people to pray, but I always get that response. "Oh, I don't know how to pray." What? Or, "Oh, I'm not a very good prayer." Come on, what? You don't even have to be creative. Like, it's not like you're like making something up. Like, you're not writing a song. You're not writing a sonnet. You're not painting a picture. You're talking to God. You're talking to the eternal presence that created you. You're talking to the most intimate thing you could ever imagine. That knows everything about you. That knows every secret about you. That knows all your dark nooks and crannies. And still loves you. Loves the snot out of you. You ain't got nothing to hide. Don't know how to pray. It tells you right here. Jesus said, "This is how you pray." If you don't know how to pray, and somebody says, "Hey, you care to bless the food?" Right there, you can just do this prayer right here. Listen to me. It says, "Father, may your name be kept holy." This is an NLT version. It's going to sound a little different than what you're used to in your traditional King James version of the Lord's Prayer. This is Luke's version, also a bit shortened from our traditional version that we recite. "Father, may your name be kept holy. May your kingdom come soon. Give us each day the food we need, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And don't let us yield to temptation." Mic drop. Boom. That was, you don't know how to pray. Right there it is. Next time I hear someone say, "I'm not praying," I'm gonna have this on a piece of paper ready to go. There you go. If you don't know how to pray, if you're not comfortable praying, this is a great place to start because this prayer is so powerful because it's as much as Jesus, all of Jesus' teachings, you can always get more out of it. You can always dive deeper. You can always mine more nuggets of gold from every little scripture you find. Reread every scripture over and over. Don't ever stop reading scripture because you can read it 1,000 times the same scripture and God will speak to you in a different way each time. It's amazing. So don't ever stop reading scripture. Don't say, I know that verse. I don't have to read that. Oh, I've read Matthew before. Go back and reread it. It's amazing what God will do. But he says, "Father, may your name be kept holy." That's where we start with our prayers. We start with God. We start with God in all that we do. When Jesus says, "This is how you pray, God, may your name be kept holy." Boom, right there it is. First thing, that's what we establish our lives on. That's what we establish our prayer on. We are connecting with a God who is greater than anything we could ever imagine. We are communicating with the creator of a universe that we can't even fathom. We always start with a little bit of respect, right? When you meet the boss at work, when, you know, when the bishop comes to town, you always, yes, sir, yes, sir. Nice to meet you, sir. Just a matter of respect. God, you are holy. God, you are beyond anything I could ever imagine. God, I am so insignificant compared to the eternal life that is you. But get this. May your kingdom come soon. Oh, now I'm getting somewhere. It's moving. This prayer is starting to move now. It's got some flow to it. God, you are up there and amazing and powerful, and I love you, and you're up there. Now come down here. Come down here and let me be part of this kingdom. Bring that grace and mercy and love into my life. Bring it to me now. Let me experience that. Your kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven. God, everything is wonderful and powerful and majestic and peaceful and perfect up there. Now let me experience it here.
How do we do that?
Give us each day the food we need. We stay humble. We stay meek. We stay thankful. You ever notice when you got more than you need, you get a little less thankful for it? Sometimes it even becomes a burden. Sometimes good things can be a burden. Lord, give us just what we need. Just for today. Not just bread, not just food. The scripture we read, the song we sang, the body does not rely on bread alone. This is talking about the bread. Lord, give us today. We don't need to store up. We don't need to build barns. We don't need to tote away in our pack. Lord, just give me what I need today. Because when we start storing up stuff and we start making our own plans, we start doing these kind of things like this, well, I need this for that, and this for that, and this for that, we lose sight of where God's leading us. So, Lord, just give me what I need today. Keep me meek, keep me humble, and keep me thankful for what it is I need. Because if you need something, man, you're thankful for it, aren't you? Don't you kind of want to, in your life, remain thankful? Don't you always want to be thankful? Don't you want to be that kind of person? I want to be a thankful person. So, Lord, don't give me any more than I need, because I want to be thankful for what I've got. Humble ourselves. Forgive us our sins as we. Forgive us our sins as we. These are important little words. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. That's scripture. There's other scripture that says, if you bind it on earth, it's bound. If you loose it on earth, it's loose in heaven. If you forgive others their sins, they're forgiven. But if you hold them accountable, you'll be held accountable. All about humility in our relationship with God, in our relationship with others, and to top it off, Lord, don't let us yield to temptation. Because ultimately we're humans, right? We've come full circle now. Our prayer has dropped back down from heaven to the dirt. We are human beings that are so tempted, that are so misguided, that are so easily distracted. We are, oh, it's incredible. We are an incredible human. This human being thing is amazing. The flesh and blood is just so, golly, technologically, can you imagine? Can you imagine trying to create something like this from scratch? It's awesome. There's a lot to it. Man, it's ornery. Golly, it's ornery. It can't help to be. That's the way it's made.
true. I read it in the Bible. We're all ornament. We're all saved by grace. We're all born to this flesh and blood. You can't help that. It's awesome. And depending on how you look at things, it can be a pretty sweet life. Life can be a pretty sweet fruit if you take a bite of it. But there's so much more than this flesh and blood. Jesus said there will come a time when you don't worship God on a mountain or in a church or in a whatever. It's paraphrasing. He said you'll worship God in the Spirit. Because that's what God is. That's the common denominator between every single one of us in this world. We have the very Spirit of God dwelling inside us, flowing among us. Love God, love your neighbor. Love God with all your heart, mind, soul, strength. Those are important, right? When all those line up, you'll get what you want. What do you want in life? What do you want in life? Jesus goes on in this scripture to say, knock and it will be given to you. Ask and you will receive. Knock and it will be opened to you. Ask and you'll receive. Seek and you'll find. Because that's what prayer is. What do you want? You want peace, right? No, I want a Corvette. No, I want a bigger house. I think that we'd be happier if we had a bigger house. Lord, can I have a bigger house? Lord, if Aunt Sue Allen can just be healed, that's what I want. That's what I want. Healer. Are we praying for the things that we need to be praying for? Lord, help me to understand your will. What are we seeking after? Closeness with God or closeness with stuff? Closeness with this culture? Closeness with, are we really seeking God? I struggle with it all the time. Are all my efforts and energies poured into growing in my relationship with Christ? Are all my biorhythms, is everything in conjunction focus directly towards the way, the truth, and the life that Christ has called me into, that God has empowered me to do? Are all my efforts and energies poured into being the hands and feet of my Creator? Are all my efforts and energy poured into growing closer, being filled up only so that I may pour it out on those around me? Are all my efforts and energies focused on kingdom-driven things? Capital K. Sorry, that was backwards to you. Capital K. Where's our focus? Where's our effort? Where's our energy? Where's our mind? Where's our spirit? That's what God says. That's what Christ says. Love God with all your hearts. That's all your emotions. Don't be led by your emotions. Let your emotions be led by God. All your heart, all your soul, let your being. All your mind, what your thought processes, what are you thinking about in your life? What's on your mind all the time? What is it right now? Because you know, if you stop and think about it, what's on your mind all the time? Is it kingdom driven? Is it God centered? Is it Christ focused? What's on your mind all the time? What's in your emotions? What's in your mind? What's your body doing? What are you using this old flesh and blood for? Because we have control of it. You know, we can, my spirit, my mind, I can make this thing do stuff. What are we doing with our vessels? What are we doing with these earthen vessels that God has poured his spirit into? What are we doing with it? Is it kingdom focused? Is it Christ-centered? Is it God-driven? It's not? Quit? Quit doing it. Because if what you want is peace that passes understanding, because if what you want is joy and life abundant, there's only one thing that you have to focus on. That's it. It's incredibly simple, but it's incredibly difficult. If you want the peace that passes understanding that all these other earthly things promise you, you're not going to find it there. You're not going to find that joy unspeakable in a stereo speaker, or a job, or a relationship even. You are not going to find those things that you're seeking. You'll find the things you're seeking, but it's not what you think you want. Seek ye first the kingdom of God in all that you do. All your efforts, all your energy, all your thoughts, all your actions, the things you speak to people. Let it be life, that song says. I love that. When we speak, it's important that it's life-giving and encouraging. When we post stuff on social media, it's important that it's God-centered, that it's Christ-driven, that it seeks the goal that we want. What's your goal? Peace that passes understanding. You're not going to find it. So you find that one thing. It's so important. Prayer is so important because if you believe it, I swear, you can move mountains. It's incredible the power that these human bodies and human minds and human spirits possess. It's incredible what we can do. Have you ever stopped and seen some of the things that we've done in this world? Both amazingly fantastic and also just tragically and insanely horrible? Like, we are capable of mass things. Can you imagine if we put all of our focus, our collected energy, into healing this world? Into comforting the broken? Into feeding the hungry? Can you imagine if every single person on earth poured their life into the kingdom of God? What would happen? Hello, it would come here soon. On earth as it is in heaven. That's the goal. If that's your goal, speak it now. Speak it into existence. Speak it into your heart. Speak it to God. Say, God, I'm ready. That is what I want. I know what I want now. Finally, thank God, I know what I want in my life. I'm 53 years old and I finally know what I want. I'm not. I was being somebody else there. I was a character. If you're 53, I was not being you specifically. But God, I'm ready. I know now what it is you have created me to do. All this other stuff is just side gigs. I know now, Lord, what it is that this is all about. And I choose, yes, I'm going to pour my life into you. I'm going to pour my life into the kingdom. I'm going to pour my life into the church that you created. That's what this is all about. I kind of harp, you know me, I'm kind of harping on the church all the time, kind of busting our chops. But I got to keep us honest. If my wife didn't drop me a peg or two every once in a while, my head would get so big I wouldn't know what to do with it. I gotta have somebody keep me in check. That's my job. I'm trying to keep us in check. Where's our focus at? I'm talking to me too. I'm not holier than that. I'm just as rotten and ornery as you are. Maybe a little more. But where is our focus? Today, let's rededicate. I'm going to too. You know, my focus here is what do I want to be? Who do I want to be? What do I want in life? I promise you this. This is my thing. I'm just giving you mine. You can have it. You don't have to take it. Don't. Do your own thing. But my thing is, I want to love God. This is my mantra. I'm starting in the morning. God, help me to love Him with all my heart, all my mind, all my strength, and all my soul. And help me to love my neighbor as myself. That is what I want in life. I want to be that person. Not to earn anything, not to make my way into heaven. I have made this conscious decision that I believe what Jesus Christ has told me. I believe the living word of God and where it leads me and directs me. I have seen the results from His promises. I want to have that life and life abundant more. So I've made that conscious effort to pursue it. And the way we do that is we make that conscious effort.
We have to make ourselves, because our human bodies are those little guys that are just distracted by everything, right? So our spirit has to come together and say, body, psh, psh, hey! Over here. Kingdom focused. Kingdom focused. Kingdom focused. But I want to watch TV. Okay. It's a kingdom focused. Oh, crap. It's those little things, those conscious efforts. Yes, it's possible to live your life fully for Christ. But you have to be conscious about it. You have to make the effort. I struggle with it all the time. Is everything I do Christ-centered? Heck no. But I'm trying. I'm getting there. I make little progresses here and there. That's what it's about. But it's that constant, constant, constant focus. It doesn't take much to distract us spiritually, physically, emotionally, mentally. We are ADHD to the brim, us human beings. It does not take much to distract us from the one thing that will bring us true happiness, true peace, true joy, true life. So let's focus this coming week on that. Let's really dive into that. If you don't know what you want, if you don't know what it is that this life is about, if you don't know what God has in mind for you, if you're just kind of out there and you've been, life's going pretty good and it's fine, but you don't feel that presence, you don't feel that calling, you don't feel that meaning, ask now. Jesus says, if a child asks for a fish, is a father going to give him a scorpion? If he asks for a loaf of bread, is he going to give him a stone? No. If my kid wants something, if my kid's hungry, I'm not going to give him a scorpion or whatever. I don't know, can you get a scorpion these days? You eat them, you'll suffer. Maybe they like them. But my point is, how much greater is our God than our earthly fathers and our earthly selves? If we would be good to our own child when they ask for it, why would God not be good to us that much more? Ask for it this week. If you don't know what he's got in mind for you, if you don't know where you're at in this world, if you don't have that peace that passes understanding, that joy unspeakable, ask for it. Say, God, I want it. I don't know where it is, I don't know what it is, I don't know why it is, but I want it. Ask him for it. Seek it. Pursue it. And when you don't get it tomorrow, don't stop. And when you don't get it next week, don't stop. And when you don't hit the mark 10 years from now, don't stop. Because we're never going to get there. What? Ow! I'm wrapping up. I'm sorry. We're never going to get there. But man, the closer we get, the better it is. And one of these days, when that veil is lifted, and we're face to face with our Creator, and he says, "What'd you do for my kingdom down there? What part of your life did you commit to my kingdom? How much of your life did you invest in me? Perhaps I will return the investment." Whoa. That's scary. Invest your whole life. It's possible. Everything you do is a ministry if you recognize it as such. Picking up the mail in the morning. Going out to eat. Heck, even going to church is a ministry. Preaching is a ministry sometimes. And all that you do, be a minister. And all that you do, be a child of God. And all that you do, be a disciple of Christ and bring the light to the world around you. Let's go to the Lord in prayer. Gracious God, we just thank you. You are amazing. You are all powerful. God, I can't wrap my head around this creation, let alone the Creator. But Lord, just ask that you allow us to experience your kingdom here on earth. Let us be the hands and feet of Christ to usher in your reign. Lord, give us your spirit to keep us focused on your mission. Because, Lord, as broken and messed up and distracted as we are, we know that you can still use a broken stick to draw a straight line to salvation. Lord, we just ask that you create in us clean hearts. Let the kingdom expansion begin within our very own being. And let it spread like wildfire. But Lord, let it begin with me. It's in your holy name we pray. Amen. If you would now stand and sing our closing hymn. And this is a wonderful old spiritual. If it is a spiritual version of it. But we'll flip over and sing our closing hymn, Every Time I Feel the Spirit.
Play it again, Jake. Let's go out on that. Every time I...